What's going on, everybody? Welcome to today's video. In this one, we are going to be ranking all specialists in Black Ops 4 from worst to best. Now, obviously, specialists are a massive component of Black Ops 4, and I'd like to give you guys a little bit of advice and guidance on what specialists you should pick. Now, there's one general trend that I did identify while ranking these specialists. I did find that all the previous specialists from Black Ops 3 tend to be really, really bad in Black Ops 4. I'm not sure why, but they just don't seem anywhere near as powerful. And also, because this game is more team related, all the previous specialists had nothing to do with being a part of a team. Without further ado, let's get right into ranking these specialists. At number 10, we have the Prophet. This, in my opinion, is undoubtedly the worst specialist in the game. Tempest is just horrible, how you have to zap someone and then you have to finish him pretty much like Blackout. It's so pointless. Obviously, the Seeker is just so annoying, firstly, to come up against if you actually get zapped by it, but secondly, it's really not even that good because it can only take out one person, and very rarely do they fail to obviously just hit square and just let the Seeker go. So that is why Prophet is the worst specialist in my opinion. At number 9, we have the Firebreak. Now, the other reason why this isn't the worst is because Heat Wave is kind of good in this game. Purifier's range is just horrible. I feel like I've only gotten like a few kills with this, and in my opinion, just stay away from this. People think, oh, it's a flamethrower, it's so good. It is nowhere near as good as Black Ops 3, and it's just super underpowered. Obviously, Heat Wave is alright. The only thing that I dislike about it is that you actually have to be on the ground. I wish it was kind of like BO3, how you could just spray it and then you could just go and attack all the people and they'd kind of be still like a massive concussion. But obviously, for some reason, they make you prone on the ground while you do it. Obviously, I've seen a lot of tweets of people saying that this is a very annoying specialist to come up against, and it is, because when you get struck by this Heat Wave, you have to wait like a certain amount of time, firstly, to heal again, which is super annoying. And secondly, most of the time, I end up dying because I'm right next to the guy and my cold luck is horrible. Next, at number 8, we have the Battery. Now, although I actually kind of like the Battery, I also dislike it because it's just not a good specialist. It's not one that you should really look out to use. The War Machine is very weak in my opinion. It's alright for objective game modes like Control, where you're trying to shoot in like a certain place where people are going to be hiding. The cluster grenade is actually, in my opinion, really good. It's one of the best gears that you get. But just in general, I feel like Battery isn't a very good specialist. But just in general, I just don't feel like Battery is a very good specialist, and that is why it is 8th on the list. Now, if you guys haven't actually noticed, the last 3 on the list have all been from Black Ops 3, and that is exactly what I'm saying, is the old specialists from Black Ops 3 are really, really weak this year. I don't know why they did it, but everything is a lot better because obviously it's not as selfish. Like, all the specialists you just saw, the Prophet, Battery, and Firebreak, they're all selfish specialists that are only for you, and that's why they are pretty bad. At number 7, we have Torque. Now, this one was a difficult one. Personally, I don't like Torque, but I see a lot of people using it and a lot of people enjoying it. Torque is one of, if not the best specialist for objective game modes. It can easily hold off opponents very well. The shield is very overpowered. It's like better than the Guardian in Black Ops 3 and Black Ops 2. Once you get struck by it, it's very hard to get out of. Obviously, the same goes for Razor Wire. Once you're in it, it can be very hard to get out of. But the Razor Wire is a lot easier to get out of than the shield. Coming in at number 6, we have the Ruin. Ruin is one of the highest rated on the list from Black Ops 3. Obviously, last year we saw the gear as Overdrive, but that has since changed to Grappling Hook. And that, for me, has changed my opinion on this specialist. The Grappling Hook is very good if you want to consider rushing, getting to those crunch points early in the map, also just getting around the map a lot easier. It does make life pretty easy when you're using the Ruin. On the other hand, we have the Gravity Spikes. In my opinion, I'm not a fan of the Gravity Spikes, but I do know a lot of people that are, so I can't really force my opinion on this one, but just for me, it's not very strong. It's pretty weak for me, and I don't enjoy using it. At number 5, we have another Black Ops 3 specialist. However, this one is very, very different. Because if you guys don't remember, in Black Ops 3, Nomad was pretty much the Hive and the Reject. So the Hive was these little bees that if you ran in, you would kind of just get eaten up by them and you'd die. And Reject was, once you died, you could reject and revive yourself. Now we have the well-renowned Dog, which pretty much everyone hates. And we also have the Trip Mines. The Dog is just unbelievable. It's so overpowered. I think I got, at one point, I got like 6 or 7 kills with the Dog. That's really why the Nomad is up there with the best, because it's just super overpowered. And even the Trip Mines as well. If there's one thing that I want them to change about Trip Mines, is that they don't blow up straight away. They maybe have a little sound before, or just like Black Ops 3, how they pop up and you just have a chance to at least duck before just getting smacked by them. But that's my overall opinion on the Nomad. Getting into the best specialist, at number 4 we have the Ajax. The Ajax is known as one of, if not the most overpowered specialist in the game right now. I really do enjoy using this at times, depends what kind of lobby I'm in. I never used to use it, however now I am starting to use it a little bit more. The shield is just beyond overpowered, and if you know how to use it right, if you know how to keep your back away from enemy players, the shield can just be super overpowered. Also, the 9 bang is just pretty much a concussion on steroids. This thing is unbelievable. I actually can't explain how good it is. It's just broken. So if you guys want to try something out new and you haven't tried Ajax already, I would definitely suggest you guys go ahead and use that. Moving on to the top 3, at number 3, we have the Crash. This is one of the best team specialists in the game. It's very, very good for objective game modes. Also good at assisting your teammates and keeping them alive. Being able to supply your teammates with more ammo is always helpful. You get this ammo a lot as well, so this may mean that you can take off Scavenger and you can just keep on trucking down those ammo packs and you're good to go. Obviously, you also have that pad thing that gives your teammates 200 health. That not only helps your teammates, but also helps you because you also get 200 health and you also get points for every single teammate that you scan. This is a super good specialist and this is probably one of the ones that I use the most. Talking about things that I use the most, at number 2, we have the Seraph. And the Seraph is without a doubt the specialist that I use the most. The only reason why the Seraph isn't at number 1 is because it has a weapon as its sort of featured, so it can be classified as a little bit selfish. The Annihilator in this game, which is the Seraph specialist weapon, is very, very good. The amount of feeds that I've gotten with this thing is unbelievable. It's a lot better than it was in Black Ops 3, and as I said before, most of the Black Ops 3 specialists are really bad, but this one is something else. This one has been buffed up and this one is just overpowered. Looking at the gear, we have the Spawn Beacon, which is very, very good. It helps your team with objective game modes and also just keeping your team as one and perhaps keeping your team close to the action. Finally, the moment that you've all been waiting for, at number 1 we have Recon Specialist, which is pretty much everyone's number 1. In my opinion, this is the best specialist in the game. Obviously, I said my favorite specialist was the Seraph, but this is without a doubt the best. You obviously have the Sensor Dart, which is very, very helpful for the whole team. Super, super good for objective game modes and just every game mode in general. Just helps your teammates out because obviously we have a new style of minimap in this game. Finally, looking at the most unique thing about this specialist is the Vision Pulse. And the Vision Pulse is broken. It is so good. It assists your team so much. You get 3 scans if you stay alive for the scans. You get like 10 points for every scan player that you get. And this is exactly why it is at number 1, because it assists the team and it helps the team out so, so much. Anyway, guys, that is the end of today's video. If you did enjoy, make sure to drop a like. Also, subscribe if you guys have not already. Peace out and enjoy the rest of your day.